in between two lockdowns, whatever for Panorama submissions, there were a lot of film activities resumed. But still, at the end, looking at the statistics, there was around 240 plus. Do you think there was lack of awareness in submissions among the people? But there were cinema activities resumed between last year and this year.
It was all well published and everybody was knowing that Panorama, we had received many applications and 240 films, I think every year, even before pandemic also it was 240, 230. It was same kind of films and all the films have come from, even some films are made on Corona and they working from pandemic situation and working from home, the conflicts in the home when they are for the Corona or they were locked down, those conflicts are also were shot and the films were brought.
Any OTT films were also submitted?
No, we couldn't know that. I think we had seen all the censor certificate films. So I think OTT films were not there. Maybe now it may go to OTT.
It is not there.
Yeah.
This is for Manmohan sir. You just mentioned regarding quality of non-fiction, non-feature films, but still, just you made some passing remark about showing these films, because a lot of money is involved in making a film, short or big or feature, non-feature, and in India still there are no avenues to show them, to showcase them and earn money. So what is the future for this non-fiction, non-feature films in your opinion? Because you have worked with international channels also who show a lot of documentaries.
Yeah, it's a good question, because as a documentary filmmaker I have been working the last 30 years. It's very few people internationally, they commission to Indian documentary filmmakers. So that's the reason what I was doing the last 15 years is I invest my own money. I mean, and again, we have to meet the international standard. Like, use those equipments which is internationally, you know, recognized and acceptable one. It's a difficult thing for a documentary filmmaker, which I am going through because as an individual, I have done 6 films. That's the reason I just selected Wildlife. So that's only things, you know, few people are there and there is a demand. And that to particularly work on tigers, so there is a demand on tigers. So basically, I have to recover my money also. It's a difficult for all the documentary filmmakers. So that's the reason. See, this is the only platform they are showing this non-fiction films. They are two selected films. That's the reason I was telling the ministry should make sure that there will be some, they have to make a rule, they have to show that they should create a platform for documentaries, whether it is in Doordarshan, whatever, they have to create it, otherwise it's difficult. It's very important where everyone should, you know, raise a, you know, this thing to ministry to make sure that they, all these filmmakers should get a platform. That's why I said Marathi is a good example. The whole thing, you see, a lot of fictions, a lot of small films, because they know at least once they'll get a chance to show the film. So like that, documentary and non-feature also should get an opportunity, which we are in a very bad shape. Honestly speaking, there is no such slots in whether it's Doordarshan or private, including Netflix. We thought OTT, when the Netflix comes, we all will get an opportunity. And honestly speaking, particularly in Wildlife, they always want big films like Planet Earth and Attenborough and all these so-called big scales, hardly any documentaries, hardly any Wildlife, because they also wanted mainly subscription-based. So like mass, what works in fiction, because, so it's not that, you know, OTT comes, we are getting a chance, no. I mean, still people are struggling, still I'm pitching a project to OTT, they say, no, we want a big series. For example, in Wildlife, to creating a 4-part series for an individual, it is not an easy job. So it is very, we need to work on it, government definitely needs to put
funding also is another issue for them,
no?
Yeah. Funding is a big issue.
Very big issue. No one funds, hardly, no corporate people fund for anything. Hardly anyone. There's no environment or any documentary slot in any channels, whether it's private or this thing. You get easy funding for game shows and, you know, what do you call that, other thing, but not for documentary.
Ek chota sa sawal, madam, is there. Did you find any woman filmmaker in this field?
Yes, many. बहुत सारे थे और issues भी ज़्यादातर women centric थे. तो जैसे कि मैं लेखक हूँ और एक लेडी भी हूँ, तो हम लोगों ने जूरी के पूरी सहमति होती थी कि किसी भी फीमेल सेंट्रिक फिल्म को हम तवज्जो दें. और सबसे ज़्यादा भाषाओं पे, तो जो संथाली फिल्म हमने चुनी थी, तो इस तरह की चीज़ें जो बिल्कुल ऐसी दुर्लभ भाषाएं हैं. संबलपुरी एक फिल्म, संबलपुरी भाषा में एक फिल्म थी, और बहुत ऐसे दूर दराज के इलाकों की फिल्में थी जिनको हमने चुना. और
जी
हाँ बिल्कुल और बहुत सारी ऐसी चीज़ें थी जिनको चुनने में हमें अच्छा लगा. लेकिन जिस तरह की बात हो रही थी कि कम संख्या में फिल्में चुनने को मिला, तो अंत में आते आते हम सब लोग एक फिल्म के तो पीछे ही पड़ गए थे कि प्लीज़ इसे ले लीजिए किसी भी तरह, क्योंकि दो फिल्मों के बीच में ऐसा लग रहा था कि एक फिल्म छूट रही है जो बहुत ही बेहतरीन थी. तो ये बहुत ही अच्छा अनुभव रहा, और मुझे लगता है कि आगे बहुत सारी फीमेल फिल्म मेकर्स हमारे सामने आएंगी और बहुत सारी फिल्में हम लोग उसमें शामिल कर सकेंगे.
कहना चाहता हूँ वो ये कि जो आपने अभी कहा कि ये जो डॉक्यूमेंट्री नॉन फीचर डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज है, तो उसके लिए बहुत दिनों से ये बात कही जा रही है. और अपने